Hello everyone, and welcome to Nuddle, the best platform around for distance learning in business, finance, economics, and much, much more. My name is Sava, and today we are finally finishing our journey into the dividend discount model. Today, we're going to talk about the two-period DDM that is a very useful tool to value stocks of companies that are recently incorporated, that are in high growth stage, that are expanding their operations at a very high rate. During our last two videos on DDM, we encountered a problem. For companies like Intel Corp, both the historical dividend growth rate and the sustainable growth rate are much, much higher than the required rate of return, and it means that the constant growth dividend discount model is unfortunately unapplicable. Two-period DDM is specifically designed to address this issue. In two-period DDM, the assumption that we make is that a company will grow at a very high growth rate for a number of years, and then it will reach maturity and then indefinitely grow at a much lower rate. It sounds plausible, but it's quite not that obvious. For how long the company will grow at a higher rate, when will it reach maturity, and most obviously, what would be the growth rate at maturity? In finance models and in valuation, we often make assumptions that might sound unreasonable, but overall work pretty well. Most commonly, it is assumed that a company will continue growing at the high growth rate for 5 years, because five is a nice round number, and growth rate at maturity is either equal to the risk-free rate at that particular country, and we discussed risk-free rate in quite a lot of detail in previous videos, or growth rate at maturity should be equal to the long-term growth rate of the overall economy. Mature companies can't grow at a much higher rate than the economy in general. That's at least the assumption. So here, we assume that growth rate at maturity should be equal to the long-term growth rate forecast for countries where these companies are headquartered in. So for Diageo, that is headquartered in the UK, the long-term forecast for UK economic growth rate is 1.8% per year. And for US and the Netherlands, for Intel Corp and Royal Dutch Shell, respectively, the long-term economic growth forecast is slightly higher at 2.1% a year. So those would be the assumed growth rates at maturity for those three companies. The high growth rate is generally assessed at the current sustainable growth rate. If a company reinvests a lot to expand its operations, it's reasonable to assume that that's will be the growth rate at the high growth stage. So the high growth rate will be just equal to the sustainable growth rate that we already calculated last time. So slightly below 17% for Diageo, slightly below 4% for Royal Dutch Shell, and slightly above 21% for Intel Corp. Now we need to calculate the cash flows that we'll get from holding these stocks during the high growth stage, and later on when they reach maturity and grow indefinitely at 1.8 to 2.1%. So at year zero, and this is the previous year, the cash flow for holding the stock is just the past dividend they paid. Remember, there is nothing more and nothing less to a stock in terms of cash flows than the dividends that these companies pay. So this is just the most recent dividend that is paid at year zero, and this is the dividend that we are not getting by buying the stock today, because, well, this dividend has been already distributed to shareholders before we even considered buying those three stocks. At year one, the past dividend will grow at the high growth rate. So we need to multiply the dividend in the previous year by 1 plus the high growth rate, the growth rate at the high growth stage, which is equal to the sustainable growth rate in our case. And we need to lock the row, because we will apply the same growth rate for each of the companies during the 5 years when they are expected to grow at a high rate. So now we can apply the same logic for all three companies for all 5 years when they grow rapidly. And we can see how fast dividends grow, especially for Intel Corp and Diageo at those very, very high growth rates. But then after 5 years, they reach maturity and start growing at a much lower rate. So to figure out the future dividend that we get at year six, we just need to multiply the dividends that we are expected to get at year five times one plus growth rate at maturity. And those are the future dividends at year six that we will get, and at least we're expected to get from those three companies. And now, as we assume that the companies reach maturity and grow indefinitely at those three low growth rates, we can apply the constant growth model for these companies at the point in time when they finally start growing at a low rate. So we can calculate fair values for those three stocks using the constant growth model, but for the point in time 6 years ahead from now. So to do that, we'll just divide the future dividend in year six by the required rate of return minus growth rate at maturity. And we can assess how these three stocks will be valued 6 years from now. And these would be the cash flows that we'll get from those stocks at year six. We just compressed the infinite dividend stream from year six all the way to infinity into one estimation, which is the fair value. So the cash flow in year six would be just the fair share price as per the constant growth model using the maturity growth rate. So these are the cash flows, but now we need to discount them using appropriate discount factors. Calculating discount factors is very easy. Cash flows for all three companies are discounted at their required rates of return, as this is a discount rate that accounts for respective risk. And our discount factor would be just equal to the usual formula, 1 divided by 1 plus the required rate of return, and make sure that you lock the row as the required rate of return, the discount rate, is the same for a particular company across all years, but differs across the companies. And we need to raise it to the power of the number of the year as our discount factor becomes smaller and smaller as we move forward into the future. So to the power of this, and we need to lock the column as we want to apply this formula for all three columns. And the discount factor at year zero is obviously equal to one, as there is no time value of money aspect at the present day. But as we apply it for continuous years, we can see that the discount factor indeed becomes smaller and smaller as time passes by. Now we need to multiply our cash flows by respective discount factors for respective years to get discounted cash flows that we can then sum up to get our fair values. This is very straightforward. We just multiply the cash flow by the respective discount factor. And we can drag it around and simultaneously discount all the cash flows that we care about. Now, to get the fair value from the two-period DDM, we need to sum up all of the cash flows, but excluding the cash flow at the year zero, as remember, that is the dividend that we're not entitled to get. And we can track that and get fair valuations for all three companies using the two-period dividend discount model. And we can see that apart from Roll That Shell, that's marginally undervalued at £22.44 compared to £23.10, those two companies at high growth stage, which are Diageo and Intel Corp, are quite substantially overvalued at their current market prices. And that is DDM. That's three different types of assumptions that you make when using dividends to value stocks. And this is the logic that you might want to follow to choose either of the three concepts to value a particular stock of your choice. Hope it was helpful and stay tuned. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, leave a like under this video if you found it helpful, and please, in the comments below, state what other videos on business, economics, or finance topics you want to see next. Thank you very much and goodbye.